Hello, I'm Stephen Burns, and please allow me to share with you those artists who have influenced me in how I create, as well as in the direction that I choose to create in. Now, Ansel Adams taught me about beauty, about form, and by creating in black and white, it taught me about the importance of composition. It also taught me how simple tonal values, black and white values, can produce a more dynamic outcome. Brett Weston, for me, actually went beyond Ansel in terms of utilizing the shape, form, line, and design to introduce a human element within inanimate objects. And also, he taught me the greater importance of using bold values within my work. Minor White utilized texture. This is where I really was influenced in how to utilize texture in almost a spiritual level. Lighting, luminous values, texturous values, and nondescript shapes to create depth in my work. Aaron Siskind was the one that really opened my eyes to the possibilities of abstraction. Simple shapes, simple tonal values in relations to one another, texture, all blended together to voice a whole new pattern and composition on the canvas. Jackson Pollock, for me, was a great inspiration in that he broke all the rules of how to prepare a canvas. His work was about rhythm, it was about energy, it was about form that was unique to him, and he really inspired me to use my medium that I've chosen to go beyond what it does naturally. William de Kooning utilized the portrait in very much the same way that Jackson utilized his canvases, in that he's taken simple shapes, line design, and color to go beyond the literal portrait to express a whole new meaning than what he saw standing before him. Now, Refeito Lam is from Cuba, and the Cubism movement was highly influenced him, but he introduced his own culture within his Cubism style paintings, and this really taught me to start introducing my unique culture and voice within my work. Mark Rothko really opened my eyes to utilizing nondescript shapes and color and forms to become a little bit more subtler in what I do, as well to express a little bit of a different voice within my work. So I'm really hoping that, from what you're seeing here is some of the influences that I've just shared with you. Some use of abstraction, some a lot of use of texture, some figurative. I'm blending a lot of different techniques, digital painting, compositing, photography, sometimes 3D, and we're going to share that with you in just a little bit. So I'm hoping during my time here at the Photo Festival that I inspire you to take your medium beyond what it does naturally, beyond what the camera does naturally, to voice your own unique vision. So allow other cultures, allow your culture to come through your work. So I never know what the end result's going to be. I simply work from my spirit, from my heart, and allow it to tell me what direction I should go. Therefore, your experiences in life become actually the most important thing as being an artist. Part of being an artist is learning new things, and 3D has always been a challenge to me. But 3D has also allowed me to voice myself in a whole nother direction. For me, it can be whimsical, it can be fun, it can be contemplative, and it can be commercial at the same time. So I'm exploring a lot of different avenues, and once again, I'm blending all these different techniques of digital painting, 3D, compositing, photography, and the whole purpose here is to actually go beyond what the medium does naturally. So I'm hoping to inspire all of those concepts into you here as well. If you walk away with anything from any of my workshops, it's that you've learned to become unique and how to apply your work uniquely. I'm Stephen Burns. Thank you for listening. Enjoy.